macOS Monterey gives you the power to accomplish more than ever and helps you work fluidly across all of your devices. With Universal Control, you can now use a single mouse and keyboard to move between your Mac and iPad for a seamless experience. And check this out. Without any other setup, I'm gonna simply move my Mac cursor towards my iPad, and the iPad automatically recognizes it. And if I move a bit further, boom, my cursor is now on the iPad. Now it's easy to control my iPad with just the keyboard and trackpad on my Mac. For instance, I can click and close this document and flick on my trackpad to return to my iPad home screen. Of course, I can swipe between my pages of apps, and I can use my MacBook's keyboard to open Spotlight and say, launch Notes. With Universal Control, I can even drag and drop files between my devices. I'm just gonna take this drawing I finished on my iPad and drop it on the Keynote on my Mac. Awesome. Now I can use the trackpad on my MacBook to control my iMac as well. I can also switch to use my iMac's keyboard and mouse. And this is so cool. Watch this. Now I have a title text image I've been working on here in Procreate on my iPad. Now I'm gonna take this image and drag it across all three devices and drop it in to Final Cut. Just like that. AirPlay to Mac. You can play, present, and share just about anything. As you draw a sketch on iPad, your colleagues can follow along on the bigger display. And you can even take advantage of AnyMac's high-fidelity sound by using it as an AirPlay speaker. And this year, we're bringing shortcuts to the Mac. You get access to a rich gallery of pre-built shortcuts designed just for Mac. You can set up a shortcut to instantly share selected files with your friends so they never miss a moment. And with the Shortcuts Editor, you can easily link together a series of actions to design shortcuts for your specific workflows. Automator will continue to be supported, and you can import Automator workflows into Shortcuts beginning day one.
Let's start with Safari's gorgeous new tab design. I can click on the active tab to see the page's full address, and then I can search right from here. Reader is in the tab bar whenever I need it, and everything else is right here in the More menu. Check this out. As I switch tabs, the tab bar takes on the color of the site that I'm viewing, so it feels like a part of the page. It looks beautiful. Tab groups are an easy and lightweight way to save your tabs and pick them back up later. I'll open the new redesigned sidebar, and I have a few tab groups here already. Each of these groups is a whole set of tabs. I use them for meal planning, for news, and for gift shopping. What's so powerful about tab groups is that they're on all my devices. I've got my MacBook here, and look, my new tab group is here already.
On iPhone, we've done something really special. The new tab bar appears with just a tap, and it's directly under your thumb. And when you scroll, the bar moves seamlessly out of the way. It's now easier and more natural to access your other tabs, too. You can just swipe over the tab bar to move quickly between them, or swipe up the tab bar to reveal a brand new grid view of all your tabs. And now we're bringing web extensions to iPhone and iPad. And Safari is more customizable than ever with the new start page and extensions on iOS and iPadOS.
Our OS releases will be available as developer betas today. And each of them will have a public beta next month. And all of this incredible software will be available to all of our users this fall.